Hello everyone, welcome to Biochemistry Simplified. We are discussing medical biotechnology, and in medical biotechnology we have already discussed the techniques of chromatography, and we are in the process of discussing the techniques of electrophoresis. In electrophoresis, so far we have discussed the gel electrophoresis and the blotting techniques. Now we are going to discuss a very important technique of electrophoresis, that is isoelectric focusing. First, let me give you some basics of the behavior of protein due to the change in the pH. Every protein has got ionizable groups on the surface. Some are positively charged, some are negatively charged. And the charge on the protein is a sum total of all the charges on the surface. Like in this particular case, the total charge on the protein, the net charge on the protein is 2 plus. Let us suppose the pH of the surrounding medium is very, very low, means lot of H-ions are present in the surrounding medium. Now these H-ions will bind to the negative charges on the surface of protein and neutralize them. In this case, the pH of the charge on the protein is 6 plus. Let us look at a different scenario. When the pH is high, pH is very, very high, means there are very few H-ions present in the surrounding medium. In that case, the protein will give up its positive charge as H-ion. So the positive charges are given up as H-ions. So the sum total of the charge on the protein will now be minus 4. So the charge on the surface of protein keeps changing depending on the change in the pH of the surrounding medium. So every protein has got a net positive charge or net negative charge depending on the pH. Now there is a situation when the charge on the protein is zero, means there are equal amount of positive and negative charge on the surface of protein. So the net charge on the protein is zero. When this happens, the protein is called isoelectric species, means because it does not move in the electrical field. It is also called zwitterion. So we can call it as isoelectric species or zwitterion. And when this happens, the pH of the surrounding medium is called isoelectric pH or PI in short. So isoelectric pH or PI is that pH at which a protein exists as isoelectric species or zwitterion, means it has zero net charge and it does not move in the electrical field. So every protein has a specific PI value. When the pH of the surrounding medium is equal to its PI value, the protein has zero net charge. And when the pH is lesser than PI, the protein has net positive charge. Now remember this, pH less means more H-ion. Low pH means more H-ion concentration, more positivity. Right, so pH less than PI, positivity, so protein has net positive charge. And opposite of it is, when the pH is more than PI, the protein has net negative charge. And the pH is equal to PI, the protein has zero net charge. So that is how the charge of the protein keeps changing as per the change of the pH of the surrounding medium. Let us suppose these are three different proteins with three different PI values, and this is the scale of pH. On the scale of pH, when the pH is very high, all the three proteins are negatively charged. Now we decrease the pH. As we keep on decreasing the pH, once the pH reaches 9, the charge on the first protein will be 0. Net charge on the first protein will be 0 because that is its isoelectric pH. Rest two proteins are still negative. Now we further decrease the pH to 6. Now the first protein will be positively charged, second protein will be having 0 net charge, and the third protein is still negative. Now we further decrease the pH to 4. The second protein also becomes positively charged. The third protein becomes neutral. It has zero net charge. And on further decreasing the pH, the third protein also becomes positively charged. So this is how the charge on the protein varies depending on the pH of the surrounding medium. Let us suppose this is a glass slide with agarose gel laid over it, and in this agarose gel we carry out electrophoresis, and initially we run a mixture of ampholytes. So when we carry out the electrophoresis, when we apply the current, the amphiloids get distributed in such a manner that they create a pH gradient. So on this gel, a gradient of pH is created, either decreasing in this order or increasing in this order. So there's a gradient of pH. Now suppose these are three different proteins with three different pi values, and all the three proteins are subjected to electrophoresis, because in the beginning the pH is high, so all the three proteins are negatively charged, so they will move towards anode, but they keep moving till they reach a situation, they reach a place where the pH is 9. Now at this place the charge on the first protein becomes 0, so it stops moving. The rest of the two proteins keep moving. Now they reach a place where the pH is 6. Now the second protein also becomes neutral. Now it becomes isoelectric species or zwitterion. Now it stops moving in the electrical field, but the third protein keeps moving till it reaches a place where the pH is 4. Now this protein also has a zero net charge. So all the three proteins have been separated on the basis of their pi. So proteins are separated on the purely on the basis of pi. This is called isoelectric focusing, IEF in short. Let us suppose we have a mixture of proteins with different pi values. All the proteins are subjected to electrophoresis, so they will migrate to their pi value, they will migrate to the place of the gel which matches their pi value by the technique of isoelectric focusing. Now the proteins have been separated on the basis of pi. Now the gel is removed and it is placed over another gel, that is polyacrylamide gel with SDS. So we carry out SDS page, and this SDS page is carried out in vertical direction. Originally IEF was carried out in horizontal direction, the SDS page is carried out in the vertical direction now. So when the SDS page is carried out, the proteins are separated on the basis of MR, relative molecular size, relative molecular weight. So these proteins are separated. So in the first dimension, the proteins are separated on the basis of pi by the technique of isoelectric focusing. And in second dimension, the proteins are separated on the basis of their relative molecular mass or relative molecular weight by the technique of SDS page. This is called 2D electrophoresis, or two-dimensional electrophoresis. And the advantage of this technique is that it is the technique with best resolution. It is an electrophoretic technique with best resolution. Earlier we have discussed about HPLC, that is a chromatographic technique with best resolution, that is HPLC. Electrophoretic technique with best resolution is 2D electrophoresis. This is how it looks like practically. So we have discussed the different techniques of electrophoresis. Now let us revise the points that we have studied so far. First is that polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis is basically for analysis of proteins, and agarose for analysis of nucleic acids. The dye that is used in case of proteins is the CBB for staining and BPB for tracking. For nucleic acids, the dye ethidium bromide, acridine orange and cyberglaine. Ethidium bromide excited by UV light gives orange fluorescence. Acridine orange excited by blue light gives blue fluorescence in DNA and orange in RNA. Cybergreen excited by blue light gives green fluorescence. And the probes which are used for protein, it is a monoclonal antibody probe. For nucleic acid, it is a synthetic oligonucleotide probe, which can be RNA probe or cDNA probe. And the labels that are used for the probes, for both the probes, the same labels are used, that is the fluorescent label or fluorescent probe we use, radio labeled probe, enzyme tagged probe and the biotin tagged probe. In the radio labeled probe, the point to remember is S35 is the radioisotope used for antibody probe, and P32 is the radioisotope for synthetic oligonucleotide probe, or simply remember sulfur for protein, phosphorus for nucleic acid. Sulfur for protein, sulfur for protein, phosphorus for nucleic acid. So that is the radioisotope used for labeling the radioactive probe. For enzyme tagged probe, there are two enzymes, HRP and ALP, that is horse radish peroxidase and alkaline phosphatase. HRP converts TMB to blue product, ALP converts PNPP to yellow product. TMB stands for tetramethylbenzidine. PNPP stands for para nitrophenyl phosphate. So these are the two important enzymes which are used in the enzyme tag probe. Lastly, the biotin tag probe. And the point to remember is biotin has a strong bonding with avidin and streptavidin. Some more points to remember. Blotting technique. Southern blotting for DNA, northern for RNA, western for proteins. The original name is coming after the name of the scientist who developed it in 1975 for DNA, that is Edwin Southern. That is why in southern blotting the S is always capital. It is the name of the scientist who devised it for the very first time in 1975 for DNA. For RNA, that same technique was applied. It was given the name northern blotting. For protein, the same technique was applied. It was given the name western blotting. So northern blotting and western blotting are in reference to southern blotting. And southern blotting is after the name of the scientist. The technique separating the proteins purely by size, that is gel filtration, gel permeation, molecular sieving, or size exclusion, chromatography, all these are the name of the same chromatography technique, and it separates the proteins by the tumbling radius, on the basis of the tumbling radius or Stokes radius. And in protein and in electrophoresis, the technique which separates the proteins purely by sizes, SDSP, is, to be specific, it separates the proteins by MR, relative molecular mass or relative molecular size. The technique which separates the protein purely by charge, that is ion exchange chromatography. Ion exchange chromatography separates the proteins purely on the basis of charge. While the technique which separates the proteins or amino acids purely on the basis of PI is isoelectric focusing. IEC, purely on the basis of charge. IEF, purely on the basis of PI. pH less than PI, net positive charge. Low pH, high HIN concentration means positivity, more positive charge. So pH less than PI, net positive charge. pH more than PI, net negative charge. And the pH equal to PI, zero net charge. Electrophoresis with best resolution is 2D electrophoresis. And if you remember, the chromatography with best resolution is HPLC. So with that, we end our discussion. Now in the next few lectures, we will be discussing the individual techniques of molecular biology and immunology. Thank you.